الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. صدق الله مولانا العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. والصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا نبي الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا نور الله. All praise, honor, glory belongs to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Endless peace, salutation, blessings upon our Master Sayyidina Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam, upon his noble companions, the wise and the Ahlul Bayt. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all faith to reap the blessings of this noble day and give us tawfiq to remember him Azza wa Jalla and follow the footsteps of his beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, we have been favored once more with the occasion of Eid al-Adha, which is the occasion of joy and happiness for the believers in the bounty and mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and commemorating a great sacrifice, a great qurbani, and a great love and affiliation of Sayyidina Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wa salam. And Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam was that great prophet of Allah who was tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that which he loved the most. And in that which he loved the most was his beloved son Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. From all the gifts of Allah Azza wa Jalla, he loved him the most. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to sacrifice his son in the way of Allah, Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam did not even think twice. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the sign, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam immediately went and carried out the command. And as we know from the narration, when did this? Allah Azza wa Jalla commanded Jibreel alayhi salam to come down from the heavens and descend to the earth and replace Nabi Ismail alayhi salam with Allah. And then the Qurbani and the Rawaj began from there. What is the wisdom behind this? What is the reasoning behind this? What can believers take from this? We can take from this that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in reality, he did not want the source of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. He did not want Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. Whether Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam had the common love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether the level of muhabbat was there. And this is why the Prophet of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam also mentioned, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من ولده ووالده والناس أجمعين. سرکار مدینہ نور قلب و سینہ معطر پسینہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی حدیث پاک ہے کہ تم اس وقت تک کامل مومن نہیں ہو سکتے جب تک تمہارا ایمان، تمہاری محبت اپنے والدین سے، اپنے بچوں سے اور تمام لوگوں سے میری طرف محبت سے زیادہ نہ ہو. سبحان اللہ. تو جب تک میری محبت سب چیزوں سے زیادہ نہیں ہوتی تمہارے دل میں، تمہارا ایمان پائے پائے تک نہیں پہنچ سکتا. یہ سرکار کی حدیث اور ہم دیکھتے ہیں جب یہ حب رسول کا ذکر ہوا ہے، عین حقیقت میں در حقیقت حب رسول محبت اللہ کی، اور اللہ کی جو محبت ہے وہ رسول اللہ کی محبت ہے. سو وین رسول اللہ علیہ السلام مینشن دس، Muslims need to understand, we need to learn and understand that we will not reach that level of iman until we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything, more than everything. This is the lesson of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. He loved Allah azza wa jalla more than anything, more than his own beloved son, more than his own life. He gave everything for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we look at the current state of affairs, the current state of the Ummah, and we reflect on our state, we see that our youngsters and our elders, our society is living in a state of somewhat ghafla. We have forgotten the true ways of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What has Eid become? And what is Eid in reality? Eid is supposed to be sacrificed, but Eid has become a time of indulgence. Everyone is driving a flashy car. Everyone is competing in getting the best clothes. Everyone is wanting to have the better thing in dunya than the other. But what was the original purpose of the Eid? Was this the original message of the Anbiya alayhi salam? Allahu Akbar. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentions in a hadith, he mentions that the night of Eid, the night before Eid al-Fitr, the night before Eid al-Adha, that these nights, one who stands for salah in these nights, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep his heart alive on that day when all the people's hearts will die. Sarkar Madina sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki hadith sheef hai ki us jo shakhs Eid ki raaton ko ibadat mein guzarta hai, qiyam mein rehta hai, Eid ki raaton, to Allah tbaraka wa taala wo jaza ki ummeed rakhta hota hai, to Allah tbaraka wa taala uski dil ko us din murda nahi karega jis din tamam logon ke dil murda honge. ان لوگوں کے دل مردہ نہیں ہوں گے, ان لوگوں کے جو عید کی رات کو عبادت میں گزارتے ہیں. آج ہم دیکھتے ہیں ان کی رات, خاص کر رمضان شریف کے بعد لوگ کہتے ہیں چاند رات ہے, اس میں کیا ہوتا ہے, مرد عورتوں کا اختلاط ہوتا ہے, میوزک ہوتا ہے, گانا بجا ہوتا ہے, شراب نوشی ہوتی ہے, یہ حرام کام ہوتے ہیں, یہ عام ہو گئے ہیں, تو لوگ کیا کرتے ہیں انہی کاموں میں پڑے پڑے. تو جب والدین سوال کرتے ہیں کہ ہمارے بچے ہمارے نہیں بنتے, ہماری بات نہیں مانتے, تو اس کا مطلب کیا ہے, اس کا ریزن کیا, اس کی وجہ کیا ہے؟ امام شافعی رحمۃ اللہ تعالی کا ایک قول ذریع ہے, وہ فرماتے ہیں کہ جو شخص اللہ کا نہیں بنتا وہ تمہارا نہیں بنے گا. امام شافعی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ سے a person who cannot be Allah سبحانہ وتعالی, he cannot even belong to Allah, he can never belong to you. If he cannot show loyalty to his Lord, how will he show loyalty to you? And in the same way, when parents try to speak of their children, if a child will listen to the parents once, when the father is saying, Sundar, aaj yahan jana hai, kaam hai, zaruri, to bachcha kehta hai, nahi maan. Baap kehta hai, yahan jana hai, ye kaam karo, uttar ye kaam na karo, isse parhez karo. Manta bhi nahi. تو پھر جب مانتا نہیں کیا ہم اس کو اچھا بیٹا سمجھیں گے, اس کو اچھا گمان کریں گے؟ ہرگز نہیں. تو جب جب رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا حکم تھا کہ نماز قائم کرو, روزے رکھو, حج ادا کرو, زکات دو, صدقات دو, ان جیسے کاموں میں انہوں نے رغبت دلائی اور حرام کاموں سے انہوں نے وعید منع فرمایا, تو ہم اس طرف مائل ہیں اور نیکی کی طرف ہم نے کہتے ہیں جاتے بھی نہیں, تو کیا ہم اپنے آپ کو خوب اچھا مسلمان کہہ سکتے ہیں؟ ہم اس دعوے میں صحیح کہہ رہے ہیں یا ہمارا دعویٰ جھوٹا ہے؟ یہ دعویٰ جھوٹا ہے. اللہ تعالیٰ نے قرآن کریم میں کیا فرمایا, قل ان کنتم تحبون اللہ فاتبعونی یحببکم اللہ ویغفر لکم ذنوبکم واللہ غفور رحیم. اللہ تعالیٰ نے فرمایا, اے پیارے محبوب, ان لوگوں کو خطاب دو کہ اگر تم اللہ کی محبت کرتے ہو تو میری اتباع کرو, میری سنت کو لازم پکڑو, میری اتباع کرو تو اللہ تعالیٰ آپ سے محبت کرے گا اور ضرور تمہارے گناہوں کو معاف کرے گا, اور اللہ تعالیٰ نہایت ہی مہربان اور رحیم ہے, غفور الرحیم. اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم tells رسول اللہ علیہ السلام that, oh beloved, tell the people, if you love Allah, then follow me. Follow me. Allah will love you. Allah will love you and He will forgive for you your wrongs. And Allah is forgiving and merciful. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this standard, then we as believers must rise to this standard. We must rectify ourselves. Nowadays, the trend has changed. And people are buying one another over dunya. Who's got the flashiest car? Who's got the most bling? The best watch? The jewelry? The chains? Brothers competing with one another over the best cars, the best design gear. This kind of stuff is the mindset of the youth. And this is what they aspire to be. They aspire to be people like pop stars. They aspire to be like rappers talk about.
You know, the dunya.
They want to be like this. They want to be better than the next one. Why? Because this is all the thinking that is filling their heads. The reason being, they have a void. The void is there is no connection with Deen Islam. There is no connection with Deen Islam. If there is no connection with the heart, then the heart seeks solace with other things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah bi dhikri Allahi tatma'inu al-qulub. That indeed with the remembrance of Allah, the hearts find peace. Beshak Allah ta'ala ki zikr mein, dino ko sukoon milta hai. Itminaan qalb milta hai. Lekin jis din mein Allah ka zikr, Rasulullah alayhi sallallahu alayhi sallam ka zikr na ho, to us din mein bechaini hogi, beqarari hogi. To wo kya karega? Wo shakhs kabhi music mein padega. وہ کبھی نشہ ہر ہوگا وہ نشے میں جائے he's going to turn to alcohol, to drugs, to music, to other things. Why? You must forget. This is mentality of the youngsters nowadays. They want to forget. They don't want to know. Why is this? Why are they doing these kind of things? Because they don't want to face reality. They don't want to face reality. Reality is that we have created مَا خَلَقْتَ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْلَمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, I have not created man and jinn except. Jinn and mankind except for what? That they worship. That they do the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when this local connection, affiliation is not with Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the heart, then the heart seeks these other things. And what is the reason he is seeking these other things? Is the emptiness inside. That emptiness we all feel inside, right? That emptiness has to be filled with the love of Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, a person will go constantly seeking it elsewhere, but never find that inner fulfillment. But our elders must also reflect and understand that the bachchon ki jo soch hai, ye jo galtfehmi hai, ye kaise aayi hai? Inka pehla dost kaun hai? Hum jante hain TV hai. Sab barbaadi iski hai. Jab ye TV par dekhte hain, jo film star hote hain, فٹبال پلیئر ہوتے ہیں, مووی سٹار ہوتے ہیں, جو گانا بانے والے لوگ ہوتے ہیں, یہ ان کو دیکھ کر متاثر ہوتے ہیں. تو یہ بھی ان کے ذہن میں سوچ ہوتی ہے کہ ہم بھی ان جیسا لباس پہنیں, ہم بھی ان جیسا لہجہ اوٹ مار کریں, ہماری باڈی بھی, ہمارا انداز ان کی طرح ہو, ہماری زندگی کا لائف سٹائل بھی ان کی طرح ہو. تو اس کی وجہ کیا ہے کہ جب یہ بچپن سے ہوتے ہیں یہ ٹی وی چینل چاہتے ہیں. ٹی وی چینل کے دیکھنے کے بعد ایک اور نیا فون کیا ہو گیا ہے, فون کا آئی فون. ایوری کڈز آن آئی فون, دے آر آل آن دی آئی فون, دے آر آل آن دی انٹرنیٹ, ایوری ون از آن سوشل میڈیا. دیر از سو مچ ڈسٹریکشن. دین ہاؤ ڈو وی کنفرنٹ آل آف دس؟ ون اے چائلڈ از گیون دیز تھنگز فرام ا ینگ ایج, ہی ہیز پٹ دی پلے ود دس, یہ کٹانا ہے اس کے ساتھ کیا ہوگا. ٹھیک ہے, تو ہم خود ان کے ایمان کا جو موت کا ذریعہ ہے خود ان کو دیتے ہیں, خود ان کو ہتھیار ان کو دیں اور پھر اس کے بعد کہیں کہ اب زندہ رہتا رہے. یہ تو ہو نہیں سکتا. یو گیو دیم دی ویپنز ٹو ڈسٹروائے دیئر ایمان اینڈ دین وی ایکسپیکٹ دیئر ایمان ٹو بی پرفیکٹ. دس کینٹ ہیپن. سو وین دی چلڈرن ہیو ناٹ گاٹ ا لو آف دین اسلام فرام ا ینگ ایج, When they reach maturity, and then the parents are saying, Putter, aaj ho namaz mein. Ya Putter, meri baat maan. To phir Putter kabhi nahi lagta. You do not understand. You're speaking a different language. Why? Because he's speaking into Islam. This is why Sayyidina Hasan Basri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the great tabi'een, he states that teaching knowledge to a child is like engraving in a stone. اللہ اکبر. سید امام حسن بصری رضی اللہ عنہ کا قول ہے کہ بچوں کو علم دین سکھانا بچپن میں اس کی مثال کون سی ہے؟ پتھر میں جیسے لکیر ہوتی ہے، تو جیسے پتھر میں لکیر وہ کامل ہوتی ہے، وہ مٹنے والی نہیں، اسی طرح جب علم دین بچوں کو دیا جائے بچپن سے وہ مٹنے والا نہیں، تو جب وہ بڑے ہوں گے تو خود بخود دینی ان کا لباس ہوگا، ان کی زبان بھی دینی ہوگی، ان کے کام بھی دینی ہوں گے، ان کی سوچ بھی دینی ہوگی، تو پھر انشاءاللہ تعالی دین حق پر استقامت کے ساتھ رہیں گے اور آپ کی بات بھی مانیں گے، اور جو خود اللہ کی بات نہیں مانیں گے آپ کی کیسے مانیں گے، اور اگر والدین خود اللہ کی نہیں مانیں گے پھر کیا حال ہے؟ اللہ اللہ So the only way we rectify ourselves, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Allah does not change the state of a people until they change themselves. Allah does not change our state. And the parents have to take responsibility. When you know someone is coming home at 5, 6 in the morning, as they say, smash down his trees. Stone. On. Doesn't know where he is. And the parents... Do not question this. And as he is sending the angels to destroy the people, the angels return to Allah and say, Ya Allah, there is one man there who worships you. He never even commits wrong. So we can't punish these people. Allah says, destroy him.
Destroy him as well.
And the reason why? Because he did not frown upon seeing the evil. When he saw the munkar in society, he did not correct. He was happy with it. He was happy with the funny mixing of men and women. He was happy of the sisters not covering themselves, Islamic. He did not see. He was happy of the alcohol being served freely and consumed. He was happy of all the music and all the youngsters going astray. He did not watch. So what did Allah do? Allah destroyed all of them. So we as an ummah, we need to rise to the standard of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has expected of us. Allah mentions in Quran al-Kareem, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You are the best of people who is taken from mankind. The best of people. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say because you have the most money, or you have the best car, or you wear the best clothes. Or your shajir and nasr, your lineage is the best, or your kasab, your job is the best. No. What did Allah say? Was it because of dunya? No. He said, Ta'muruna billah. Before this, he said, Ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. Because you command good, you forbid evil, and you believe in Allah. This is why Muslims have been given the rank. Muslimano ko ye sharaf aur izaz isliye nahi diya gaya. کیونکہ ان کا شجر و شجر نصب اعلیٰ ہے یا ان کا قصب اعلیٰ ہے نہیں یا ان کی مال و دولت ہے اولاد ہے ان کام 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 اللہ تعالیٰ نے فرمایا کہ برائی سے روکتے ہیں نیکی کا حکم دیتے ہیں اور اللہ پر ایمان لاتے ہیں اس کی وجہ سے مسلمانوں کو شان ملی ہے اور آج ہمارا کیا حال ہے ایوری یونگسٹر what is their aspiration he asks these youth Now these youngsters, you might think they're dumb, they don't know anything, but trust me, they know much more than what we do in our age. Through media bombardment, these youngsters, they know everything. They know what their parents do as well. But their best example, their best role model in their life is their parents. If the parents are not following in the footsteps of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then it is very difficult for us to try to convince the youngsters to do so. The first example is the mother. Thereafter is the father. And if there is no such mindset and environment within the home, then we cannot expect to just throw them on the bus to the mother of son and say, Kari sari 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 sari. Kari sari ki baat nahi. Pehli baat hua diya baat nahi. Maa ki gor. Aur baap ki jo shafqat. Aur baap ki tarbiyat. Agar baap khud مگر اگر آپ آپشن دے رہے ہیں صحابہ کون ہیں، خلفائے راشدین بتائیں کون ہیں، پانچ تنخواہ کون ہیں، خلفائے راشدین کون ہیں، who are the خلفائے راشدین، the rightful successors of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، do our youth know who are the five noble ones، پانچ تنخواہ، the close family of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، even the basic thing to know، do the youth know who was Khalid bin Walid، who was Sayyidina Khalid bin Walid، they don't know. Why is there deficiency in our Islamic knowledge? The reason being that we have not given that mindset to the youngsters of young age. We must inculcate the Islamic mindset to the youngsters from a young age, so that when they learn and then they grow an affiliation, connection, then they will want to be like these companions. Then they will want to be like the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sisters. Allahu Akbar, what is their aspiration? Who do they look up to? They look up to Hollywood and Bollywood. All the women are dressed like dolls. They look like Christmas trees. On Eid, this is the state. Why? They don't have the correct role models. Who are your role models? Who do you aspire to be like? Who do you want to follow? Who do you want to be with? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentions Al-Mar'u ma'a man ahbaba. ہر شخص اس کے ساتھ ہوتا ہے جس سے محبت کرتا ہے۔
سبحان اللہ،
اگر آپ ان جیسے لوگوں سے محبت کریں گے انہی کے ساتھ ہوں گے کیا مطلب، اگر نیک لوگوں سے محبت کرتے ہیں ان کے ساتھ ساتھ، یو ول بی وذ دوز پیپل۔ اللہ عز و جل مینشنز ٹو اس، اف یو وانٹ ا رول ماڈل، ہی سیز لقد کان لکم فی رسول اللہ اسوۃ حسنہ، کہ بے شک رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے تمہارے لیے بہتر نمونہ ہے۔ Indeed, for you, in the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the best example. The best example that you can think of. It's in the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But now, unfortunately, those sisters who wear hijab, those sisters who dress Islamically, it's not seen as trendy. She's frowned upon. Right? Those brothers who adorn themselves, their faces with a beard. Right? Or they try to keep the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. People say, oh yeah, Maulvi sahab ho gaya, ye Sufi sahab hai. Isko rehne do. He doesn't have a clue in life. Right? Duniya ke saath saath chalna hai. Ye bhi kaam karna hai. Woh bhi duniya ke kaam bhi hoti hai na. This is the mentality. That our people, we have come to these shores of Europe. What have we gained? We sacrificed our homeland. Think about sacrifice. We sacrificed our homeland. Our forefathers came to this country, and what did we gain? We got dunya. Yes, we got dunya. We got it all. Right? We all get 2 meals a day. We get more. We get everything on a plate. You've got everything. Roof on your head. You got meals. You got warm bed at night. You got everything. We've got everything. But what have we lost? We have lost our deen in Islam. There is no deen in Islam. There is no fikr of Islam. That mentality, whereas Sahaba Ikram, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they didn't have luxuries. But what did they have? They had iman. They had the belief and the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we, on the other hand, we have our dunya. But think of sacrifice. If we have sacrificed our deen for dunya, in other words, we have lost everything. But in reality, we will sacrifice our dunya in order to gain deen. Dunya ko qurban kare deen ke khatir. Aur Allah tabarak wa taala hame dunya bhi dega deen bhi dega. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa taala will give you both dunya and also deen. So we need to remove these trends and remove these ways of thinking which are away from the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We need to make it a trend to follow the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the only thing to do. We need to make it a trend to be punctual in our salah. That is the only thing to do. The sisters need to make it a trend to cover and rest. What is this? This is the thing to do. This is in fashion. But today we see, unfortunately, the busiest place on earth is the cinema. That's the busiest place tonight. You see, the busiest place will be the road outside. Right? Brothers getting intoxicated, drunk, and you know, wasting their youth. And how many youth have we seen before our eyes? People who are musicians and entertainers, they have no value. And still they have no value. But today, everyone wants to be like that. Everyone wants to be like that. Our youngsters want to be like that. Every youngster, most of the youngsters, they want to aspire to be like people like that. But we need to change these ways. We need to break trends. And the only way, my dear brothers and elders, is to educate our youth in Deen Islam. Give them that muhabbat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Give them the muhabbat of Sahaba Kiram, Ahli Bayt, of the companions of the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the muhabbat of the awliya kiram, the friends of Allah. Make them attentive to these things in a young age. That's the only way you will break the mindset. And if you don't, then Allah Akbar. We've seen the results elsewhere. What is happening to the Ummah in Syria, in Iraq, in Palestine, in other places around the world? Why? I make an intention to pray two rakat namaz-e-eid, which is wajib, with six extra takbeers. Behind this imam facing Qibla, this is the intention. After making the intention, we say, Allahu Akbar. And the imam says, Allahu Akbar. Uske baad subhanakallah. Wa la ilaha ghayruka kabbarenge. Aur phir imam sahab teen takbeeren karenge. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Aur teesri takbeer ke baad haathon ko naaf ke niche baandhna hai. After the third takbeer, hands are tied by the navel. The imam shall do the qira'at. He recites the Quran and the followers listen. When the imam recites this, the followers do not recite Quran behind the imam. His recitation is sufficient for you, as mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The imam's recitation is enough for follow. Then the first rakat is completed as usual, and then he stands for the second rakat. And at the end of the second rakat, there's going to be a slight change. तो पहली रकत को मुकम्मल करने के बाद जैसे हम नमाज होता है और तीन तकबीरें हो चुकी हैं उसके बाद दूसरी रकत के लिए हम खड़े होंगे दूसरी रकत की आखिर में एक तब्दील आएगी वो क्या है जब रुकू का वक्त होता है तो रुकू में नहीं जाते وہاں پھر اللہ اکبر انسٹیڈ اف کرنے رکوع اللہ اکبر اللہ اکبر اینڈ دین ہی سیز دی فورتھ ٹائم اللہ اکبر رکوع ان دی سیکنڈ رکعت تو دوسری رکعت میں بھی تین تکبیریں ہیں پہلی رکعت میں بھی تین تکبیریں ہیں اور اس کے بعد نماز مکمل ہوگی اور اس کے بعد خطبہ ہوگا جو سنت ہے ان لسننگ ٹو دی خطبہ از سنہ ان افضلت ہے دعا تو اللہ تبارک و تعالیٰ سب کی حاضری قبول اور منظور فرمائے اور اگر آپ سب کھڑے ہو جائیں تو آگے آگے آ جائیں اور صفوں کو مکمل کر لیں صفوں کو درست فرما لیں کندھوں کے ساتھ کندھے ملا لیں بیچ میں کوئی خالی جگہ نہیں ہونی چاہیے پہلے صفوں کو مکمل کر کے بعد والی ساری کو بنائیں موبائل کو بلائیں آف کر دیں گے سارے پر لگا جزاک اللہ خیر